sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner of your limbs. That's your corner, nigga twinking. All you want to do is talk. I don't need to talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that. Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on number. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claim me, you my dog, and then you hold on me. Nowadays, they ain't showing real loyal. I was walking down the...
Today, from Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida, this is the National Football League. The Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers.
And we're about 5 miles northwest of downtown Tampa at beautiful Raymond James Stadium near Florida's Gulf Coast. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers. And we will not see a run back on the opening kickoff. This will be a touchback. First try on offense for the Bucs and their veteran quarterback, Tom Brady.
Well, we've all seen what Tom Brady can do on a football field for a couple of decades now. But how about his most impressive accomplishment? Moving to a different franchise and taking them to a Super Bowl title as well. Not many players can continually stiff arm Father Time the way that he has.
Brady now on first down. Open man is Howard, the tight end. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going
to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Now he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. And just a yard to go here on second down. Here's Brady. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. He was trying to find O.J. Howard at his third and short. By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last 4 or 5 plays, I'm eking over into your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play. Nothing doing on second and third down after that 9-yard gain on first. So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. And this will pin him back deep. That's going to kick out of bounds right at about the 7-yard line.
Here we go with the Packer offense, guided by their decorated QB with a long list of Pro Bowls and other accolades next to his name, of course. Aaron Rodgers leading the way.
So this is where we find out about the game plan and the trust factor, don't we? In this situation, the natural thing is take care of the ball, run it inside. Everyone cover it. Just, you know, get yourself some room and let your punter punt it out of there. But when you really got a QB you can trust, you might want to take a little shot early and try and create some space.
And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Here's Rodgers to throw. Man open, that's Marquez Valdez-Scantling. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him.
They were backed up to start the drive, but how about that aggressiveness? Firing it downfield right away. Nice job there getting out towards what would have been their normal starting position.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's 2nd down. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. Here's Rodgers. Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. And he's going to lose yardage here, back to his own 18. Now we're going to get a timeout. Appears we've got an injured Buccaneer. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Dancing to his left. That ball is caught. Marquez Valdez-Scantling. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big connection on that one. 35 yards.
A very early momentum changer there. Actually a dream killer for the defense because they forced a 3rd down. Felt like they had a good chance to get off the field defensively, and then they got hit with that big play.
Now a 1st down carry by Jones. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. 2nd and 6. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense? The next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. A gain of 4 last play. They double that here and get 8.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
7 yards, the pickup there.
It's got to the point where we see guys like that make that type of a catch. Not fair goes through my brain. That size, that speed, and now they're acting like wide receivers, too.
Yeah, tight end one-handed catches. They're kind of like wide receiver one-handed catches nowadays.
Just not right.
2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to 3rd down.
If they're going to get a 1st down out of this, they're going to have to earn it because there's been tough going in the interior there. And here we are on 3rd and 1. Be prepared. Brace yourself. There'll be some contact going on.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And Jones is not going to have the 1st down as they stop him short. We're scoreless after 1. And Crosby puts it through. And the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But the NFL, defenses are awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the 3.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop here for their 2nd drive. This one a little slow to get cooking. Just a 3-0 scoreline as they begin with a 1st and 10. to throw. It's Brady. And Gronkowski's got it. Complete over the middle.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at third and one. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. A rough go there on third down, a loss of four.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And here's Rodgers on the return. That'll go as a 46-yard punt with a return of seven. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
5 yards, now it's third and five.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
On play action, Rodgers. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there. And it's second down.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over him, and they got there to break that one up.
Rodgers will try again on second down. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
They fake the give. Now Rodgers. He'll rifle this one deep right side. He hauls it in. Valdez-Scantling for the Packers touchdown. Marquez Valdez-Scantling, 44 yards. And the Packers add six to their lead. And man, Charles, talk about zinging something in there. Those gloves, they help with one-handed catches, the fun stuff. Any padding for a rocket like that?
One would think so, but I'll guarantee you this, after that throw, his hands will hurt later. Not right now in the moment. He's just feeling good about catching it.
Yeah, a little stinger, but a touchdown. Crosby with the extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0. So the drive there took six plays, and it ends with a Packers touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Brady, this one complete to Giovanni Bernard. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Second and 6, just inside the 30. Now Brady. It's complete. He's got Gronk. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
But when you hit him on the move like that, he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam. Oh, boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. They'll run on first down. Bernard, and he'll get this forward only for about a yard, as that's going to take us to the two-minute warning. Za'Darius Smith able to get him down. We remind you in just a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Orlando and our good friend Jonathan Coachman. Coach will run through some of the numbers and the next-gen stats from this first half of football so far. Now this throw caught left side. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Jalen Darden, 57 yards. And the Bucs are able to make this a close game again. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Ryan Succop on for the point after. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. The drive summary, 4 plays, 75 yards. And it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Rodgers on the return. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They're starting to pull away with this one. Early on that first quarter, they didn't look so great offensively. What has changed?
Sometimes it's just a matter of doing what you plan to do better. Sometimes you just put that all together and you execute. Other times it's just in a simple adjustment in your game plan, finding a spot that maybe was a little weaker than maybe you thought, and going to that. So many different things, so many different ways. But right now, you gotta like what they're doing. They have put distance between themselves and their opponent.
Looking to add on here in the second quarter. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now Rodgers on the bootleg. Escaping the pressure right. He hits Adams, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
Of course we think of Aaron Rodgers as a pocket passer, but you and I both know this guy's a pure athlete. He can get outside and make plays with his legs as well.
And showed it right there outside of the pocket and on the money. A nice run there by Jones on first down as he'll wind up getting about 5, so 2nd and 5 coming up. From the 44, Rodgers. Oh, Adams, what a grab. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 16. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. A.J. Dillon, a 16-yard touchdown run. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
Extra point up and good by Crosby. And his guys will take a 10-point lead.
Mason Crosby, the kickoff for Green Bay.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
And here we go again with Tom Brady in Tampa's offense.
Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to keep that little quarterback strut going right now to make sure that his team sees him as confident. Continue to try and up his game, but just let him know, hey, if I'm around, if I'm the one calling signals and throwing the football, just follow me, we'll get there. Sometimes that will do more to elevate a team than anything else.
See if he has that confidence. Throwing again on second down. Brady looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Picked up at the 36. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point try now for Crosby. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
Again, we see Tom Brady and the Bucs set to take over.
And how does he rally the troops, so to speak? He's played well, but they're down big on the scoreboard. How does he get his guys going?
To make sure they understand it's not a me game, it's a team game. Everyone has to come together. Everyone has to up the level of play a little bit, including himself, and find a way to make some plays in order to give them a little bit of a spark and rally the team.
We'll see if they can indeed rally down big on the scoreboard right now. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Now Brady.
He's going to drop this one down to Bernard.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. Check 59. Mike. On first down, Brady.
And that's complete. It's Chris Godwin.
And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. So we've come to halftime here with the visiting Packers out on top. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one is maybe not exactly in the bag yet, but there is definitely a big mountain to climb in this third quarter. The teams are already back out there, so let's not waste any time as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. So it's the Packers set to receive the kick. They've got the lead as well as we are underway in the third quarter.
And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Packers ready to go to start quarter number three. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
From the 29, Rodgers, he'll find Aguara complete. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. That'll be third down. On third down, here's Dillon. Dillon, a first down and more. And he'll get this down to the 39-yard line. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Now a play fake. Rodgers. Got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. Now the ball comes loose, and it's picked up by the Buccaneers. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, number one on the list of things not to do when you're up three scores. And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. Now, the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They'll go again to Jones. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. Looking to throw on third and two toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target in the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find him. Find him.
So out comes a field goal team now for the second time here today. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. The kick by Crosby is good, and that will push this lead up to 20 now. So they recovered the fumble, but ultimately could not take advantage of the short field.
Definitely a lost opportunity right there. I mean, they were in prime position to put six on the board, ended up settling for three.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. Here comes the Buccaneers offense. They get their first reps of the second half. Brady and the Bucs now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Brady got his man complete over the middle. It's Evans. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Brady. They'll swing this out to Fournette. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. They'll give him 4 yards there. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Throwing now is Brady. And this is going to be incomplete.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers, both on the sidelines and in the huddle, looking at each other.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Green Bay offense ready to take over. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there. Now it'll be third down. Play action. Now it's Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams. 68 yards. And the Packers add on to their lead. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those. In this case, they took a nice shot at the end zone and made it pay off.
Crosby connects on the extra point, and that stretches the lead all the way up to 27. For the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
On second down now, Bernard. And this Green Bay defense making that play look a lot like the previous one. Both tackles behind the line of scrimmage. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Here's Johnson with a reception. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long. But a nice throw there for a good gain and a first down.
From midfield, here's Brady. On the screen, Bernard. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball, because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Meanwhile, Brady's throw pulled in by Gronkowski. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Working from the gun, it's Brady. High throw, but the catch is made. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of six. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Again, they'll throw with Brady to Evans on the slant. Touchdown, Tampa Bay! Mike Evans, 38 yards. And the Bucs get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. And when they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take them into the end zone. Extra point put through by Suckup, and the lead now down to 20. So the drive winds up going 75 yards in seven plays. And it's all finished off with a touchdown by Tampa Bay. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And this one's going to be covered up by the Packers hands team. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
Second down, another shot for Jones. And he'll go down at the 28.
Well, that was a unit that understood exactly where the first down marker was, handed it to their guy who could run it, created some space, and he got there.
Rodgers now on first down. A throw complete to the tight end, Tonyan. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. The passing game continues to be their friend. Even with a stable lead here in the fourth, Charles, they're going back to that well.
Yeah, with their overall philosophy, you know that they trust their quarterback. He's been able to throw it well. If he continues to throw these safe passes, who can blame him?
And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Packers add 6 to their lead. Great call to hand that one off, and his running back did the rest.
Someone read their keys correctly, and on the defensive side of the ball, they certainly did not, because they really essentially were just going to swarm the quarterback. They kind of guessed themselves out of the play, and guess who benefited? The guy with the football.
Now Crosby for the point after. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Just a 4-play drive that time. And the last play in the drive was a touchdown run by Aaron Jones. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Buccaneers getting ready to go as they take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Throwing on first down is Brady. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Now a quick slant as the throw is complete. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
This will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning. Brady now on first down. Johnson's got it complete. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. Brady's throw complete there to Johnson. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Brady now on first down. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. And now they're in the hurry up. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
So Brady and the Bucs need to work a little magic, third and long after that last sack.
Operating from the gun, Brady. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now Brady, gotta have this one. And this one is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Packers D comes up with a big stop. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
Green Bay's offense ready to go again. And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. So good field position for the Packers as they come up first and 10 at their own 44. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. And he'll be tackled right on the midfield logo. The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. Rodgers looking to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Extra point try now for Crosby. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The long touchdown pass gets them 6 on a very, very tidy two-play drive that time. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. Back now comes Tampa Bay. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Here's Brady to throw. And the timing a bit off that time as that one falls to the ground. Well, the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen, despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game. You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield. They had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
That's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. With that, we say so long from Tampa.